noticing yesterday that I think there's an interesting situation that happens with me, at least, where there's kind of three stages to it, or three phases to it, if you will. The first is what most people can relate to, myself very much included, not wanting to admit when you're wrong, right? The first inclination, the first phase, the first stage, whatever, is kind of protecting your mind, protecting your ego, what have you. And even if you're proven wrong, or you know, appear to be proven wrong, you don't admit it. You stay on the fact that you still think you're right, or you try and change the terms in some way to kind of explain why, even though you were wrong, you were kind of still right, right? Ultimately, you're trying to make the point that you're not wrong. And that's kind of an obvious one. Everybody kind of sees that. And I think when you start to evolve and you try and think better, in my case, when it comes to my son, I try and model a lot of behavior. That's a big one for people, is show you can admit when you're wrong. So you thought something, you said something, you accused somebody of something, whatever, you ended up being wrong, you admit it. You say, hey, I'm sorry. It looks like I got that wrong. And that's great, right? That starts to show that you are more rational, more logical, that you care more about getting to the right answer than you do about winning, or, you know, being right or whatever. You're just trying to get to the truth. You're ultimately searching for the truth. So that one, I think I try and practice a good bit, and I see myself do it with my son often, right? So that one people can get a hang around. But the third one, which is interesting, is which is preemptive to an extent. So you can admit when you're wrong, or you can try and be a little bit more thoughtful up front and admit when you're not sure, right? Admit when you're not certain, as I would say with my son, or admit when you don't know, frankly. That seems, at least for me, and I think it might be true for others, that actually seems like the hardest one to do. That one's more of an aspiration than it is a reality, but perhaps at least as important, if not more important, than admitting when you're wrong. So if you're in a situation where, right, and this came up with my son the other day, we were looking for a screwdriver, and I wasn't sure where it was, and I thought he had put it away last, and, you know, I said, it's not in the place it usually is, you know, you must have done something with it, that type of thing. And I was certain, right? In my mind, I was certain, and I was accusing him of this. And when I ultimately found the screwdriver in the place he told me it was, where it should be, I made sure to apologize. And I said, hey, you know, I'm sorry. I was wrong. I thought the screwdriver was somewhere else. I thought it wasn't in there, whatever. I thought you messed up, but you didn't. So I'm sorry. And I can admit that. But wouldn't it have been better if, in the moment, when I was accusing him of losing the screwdriver, if I could have, at that moment, kind of clicked in and said, hey, let me model this behavior. Let me say, I'm not sure. I think the screwdriver's missing. I think this might be the case, but let's check. There's an easy way for us to check here. Let's just check before I get excited, before you get excited, right? Before we make it a thing. What if I had done that? Isn't that the better scenario, ultimately? It's one, it's still modeling good behavior to him of how to, you know, try and be rational and logical. We're still getting to the truth and all that, but we're jumping that step of the accusatory phase in this case, or a potential fight that happens before then I admit I'm wrong. I think that would be better. At the least, it's as good. And it makes me wonder, why is that one so hard, though? What's trickier about that one? And in simple math terms, at least for me, it comes down to a simple reality. When you admit you're wrong, assuming you're able to do it and you're not in that kind of phase one, you're already wrong. You've lost. You don't have much option there. So the best way you could save face often, the best way to kind of maintain your ego, is to admit it and at least be the bigger person about it, because there's not much other option. You've been proven wrong. In that pre-phase, right, or that pre-step where you could, you know, admit it or acknowledge that you don't know or you're not sure beforehand, there's still a chance you might be right. There's still a chance that you've got it, and you're almost overwaiting for that and hanging on that optionality, that possibility that you might be right. You're not willing to, or at least I'm not willing to forego it. If I don't have to admit that I'm not sure, if I don't have to think better, if I can resort to the easy way, I'll do that if I can. It's almost the way you look at it. Whereas when I know I'm wrong, unless I want to just be totally stubborn and combative, I have to admit it. So interesting situation again. I think interesting to how we think and how we function, or I should say how I think and function, projecting it on others. But trying to just be cognizant of where those blind spots might be and how to kind of proactively identify them in conversations and discussions, and try and stop it from going to a bad place. Try and show and use those skills for good, ultimately, earlier on.